Hello, I'm Anna, and this is my kingdom. This is my tree. And I'm an artist born in Italy, and this is part of my paintings. This is my dog, Nika. I live in San Diego, and I love my friends and my garden. These paintings right now, I work in stages with my work. So whatever inspires me during that time, my creativity goes to that part. So right now, birds and nature and natives, the world itself is my subject. So these are immediate feelings of the birds, of nature, and a combination of feelings that I get. And this painting came about, I had so much extra glob of paint, oil paint, that I decided to just put it on the canvas and smooth it out, and it's just abstract. It's one of the few, because for me, abstract is very hard. I'm more of a figurative painter, but I love also abstract work, immediate work. This is a combination. I paint over my paintings many times. If I get tired of them and I get inspired to combine the two styles, I paint over my paintings. I don't have no hesitation for that. And I feel that this one, I succeeded in combining the straight edges with a impasto. These also are my painting. I do mixed media. That there are things that people give me or things that I find, and somehow they come together. Many of this stuff I haven't bought. They've been just given to me. This is an old painting. This is an artist friend of mine. Her work is on my wall. My friend Guy Lombardo, other artist, my son, he's a musician. These are all the. This is other artist door from my son. My studio. He's a musician. Put things, it's been like this for a long time. I put things where I feel that I want them near me. And these are things that I make, keeps me creative, things that I believe they are inspiring to me. This is my studio. It's quite small. Even the sound of my voice, I think, probably is different. I am surrounded by my work, and it just feels great. I thought at first that I was going to have trouble by working too close to my paintings, but somehow I solve these problems, you know, in an awkward way. As artists, I feel that it's not where we are, or not how small the place is. We are, I feel like, problem solvers. We expand our thoughts by where the places that we live in. And so this is my world, my paintings. And so I experiment with my paintings. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't, but I always find a way that to work with them in the way that they please me. And I, like I said, I'm in tune with, by nature. There are things that I have that remind me of my friends, that some of them passed away, and so I, but they are here in spirit with me. This is my last painting. This is my last painting. They're, my painting very, like, very, very, sometimes they're sad, but that's the quality of my work. Where I was born in Sicily, people were sad. Were in a time when they came out of wars and stuff, that they were rebuilding their city, and somehow I picked up that feeling from the fear and the hopes of new beginnings. So I have both in my painting. Even if they're sad, they still have, I like to convey the hope of a new creation, a new way of seeing things. The world recycles itself, and humans, we have to go, we can only go forward, I feel, and it's always hope for better times with everything else. I'm not sure what else to say. I'm continuing my work. I love to travel. Hopefully, I like to be with great galleries represented by galleries that I admire, people that they're passionate about artists and art. That's the people that I like to be represented of, because I certainly don't want to be with somebody that doesn't like my work. So I, well, in San Diego, we don't have that many galleries, but we have a few that I love. Well, Quint, Scott White, and Stevenson. So they're great. Hopefully one of these days I will approach them and get to know me. Yeah, these are photos of my mom, daddy, great grandma, and grandfather, and so... my great-grandfather came from Bologna in North Italy, and he came down to Sicily, and he got married, and that's the story. And that's me at Southwestern College. My husband, Dan Adams, he's also a great painter, artist. So he gave me this little pig long time ago when we first met. And it was all just clay, no painted, nothing. But when I received it from Dan, I always had the idea that I wanted to paint this little pig. And so what happened, at first I covered it with masking tape. For some reason, that's what I felt like I wanted to do. Then after a while, I took the masking tape off of it and I put it aluminum foil. Then I took the aluminum foil, and finally I painted the surface. But one day we had this little pig on the dining room table, and the whole table fell. Part of the table broke, and the poor pig fell on the floor and got broken a million pieces. So I picked it up, put it in a box, and kept it like that for a while. And then finally, after about a couple of years, I put it together. I had the patience to put it together. And I painted. And it came like brand new. you can hardly tell where all the broken parts are. So I'm very happy that I saved this little beautiful gift from my husband. I love to work large also. That is my great experience. That I did a few years ago, and it's a combination of parts of my own work. Like this is almost like a collage, but there are parts of a painting that my anger got hold of me at that time, and I tore one of my best work. And I certainly don't want to do that again. But I've ruined two of my greatest work, I feel. But they are still here. They survived because I kept them parts. And so when I was painting this, I was kind of solving this subject. Ow! Hey, Nika, you're scratching my work. I'm sorry, my dog was scratching my work. And and then at the end, because I was still searching to express myself, my ideas many times are not, I don't know how my work is going to be. I maybe have an idea at the beginning, but I never know how my work is going to end. So I keep on working until I am satisfied or I'm completely exhausted. I cannot go any farther and then I stop. So anyway, I picked up my canvas that I had torn, and I placed it on the canvas just to see if it felt like it went together. And so I kept it. So these are glued with the same type of painting, with oil paint in the back, and I pressed it against this surface. And I knew that it was completed. I didn't need it to go any farther. But the last thing I did, I wanted to unify all this as my universe, is this white circle. And so I was pleased. And the rest of this painting here, because it was a large one, it's on this. Do you want me to move? So, this is the rest of that particular painting that I got torn, and I placed it on this large canvas that also I was working for a long time, and for some reason I wasn't completely satisfied, but the moment I placed those parts there, I felt that it came together the way I liked it. And I liked what I saw, and I left it. And these two paintings have been touched for a long time. But like I said, I like to work on large canvas. And it started when I was working on a barricades downtown in 1990. It was before that. It was 19, 1988, 1989. Those were the first times that I worked on these barricades with friends of mine. We got together, had a great time downtown in San Diego, and we began to do all these beautiful shapes and animals. And when I expressed myself, you know, to work with this beautiful, freedom, that is freedom to me, when you just can go like this and splash the paint on the surface instead of going like this. It was a great feeling to me, and that made me realize that I want to work hard. And of course, you know, at home I have to be careful because, you know, you have to take consideration other people that live in a house, and I'm free with my work. Really, I am. I always give the best shot and the worst too. And so that's it. Now I want to thank my friend Guy Lombardo. He's the inspiration of my life, and to the viewer, to the people taking the time to see my world, my paintings. Thank you so much, and keep working. Ciao, Italia.
That was good. Wow. There's the end of your movie, right there.